Finley, thank you, Kevin, thank you. Okay, Matt, you're through, Jason, we're through the trees, let's go on into Lowndes County cases, and the first, your first one is RZ 2016-07, The Meadows.
Yes, sir, subject property on Demus Road, ultimately what they're asking for is a PD or site plan approval for the subject property for multifamily. One of the special aspects of this property is the multifamily is for the competition rent for low-income housing tax credit. I put some background information down with developers where they've actually done projects in Tejera and the Lake Park area that were a similar focus. With that, as I pulled up the site plan and you saw your recommendations that you had by email and also the new site plan that we have, really the main change we added there was an easement to the front of the property. We weren't convinced that cross-access for commercial office traffic through a residential area was appropriate, but we felt like the easement was justified for potential future use of development. So that was the addition across the front. In addition to that, one of the things you will notice is the developers, I will say, did start out with two-story buildings on the entire property, but to help with the privacy against those existing single-family residences on the traffic circle, went to a one-story product there, and then went to a three-story product against the vacant property to the west. I can tell you we probably have had the most questions on the subject property related to traffic and ingress, egress, just how traffic would move through the property. Ultimately, the traffic and the access improvements are going to have to be approved by the state. Bemis Road is a state route, so the ultimate authority lies with them about what will and will not get approved. Based on conversations with the county engineer and his contact with them so far, he believes they might require a deceleration lane for each of the entrances, but nothing as intense as a traffic light where that median cut is or a type of crosswalk improvement. So we felt like we did run those traffic issues down, but so far I've got nothing to report as far as a required improvement based on the traffic from the apartments. One thing I did learn since last week is that when they do their calculations for traffic, they actually count multifamily units as less of a traffic generator than single family residences. Because some of the actual traffic that goes into a multifamily, typically you might have a situation where you have more one car type families than you do with a single family household that had two or potentially more than that. So that's something I did learn, but ultimately traffic has been the focus. Have nothing to report regarding required improvements for that at this time, but ultimately the recommendation that you have before you from staff is approval. And we do believe this site plan is ready to move forward on this development.
Thank you, Jason. Commissioners, any questions for staff on this request?
Yes.
Mr. Gladden?
Excuse me. Jason, as far as the traffic count, so is the number of parking provided, does that match with what they would consider their traffic count? You know what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
How does that compare?
Our minimum requirements are two spaces per unit. So they have 80 units. They actually set forth 160 spaces. One of our initial comments to the engineer, their engineer, was, do you feel that's adequate for guest parking? You know, and they believe based on previous experience and actually the number of tenants who may not drive and their vacancy rates that it would be. So far based on their professional, we accepted their determination that they believe 160 spaces will be enough parking, and they can elaborate more on that, but that was one of our initial questions.
Commissioner Raker, yes, sir?
Yeah, just out of curiosity, at the top there where you have the gazebo and you have that parking lot that just dead ends?
Yes, sir.
Why don't they have a turnaround there for fire trucks and things like that? Is that not required on this?
The end of that parking area, you see it juts out just a tiny bit. They call it a hammerhead, where they actually give you enough to pull into a parking space and turn back around. I can ask fire rescue for that, sir. So far, they haven't indicated that they wanted to provide, you know, I know what you're talking about, like a cul-de-sac type turnaround for them. They may, but up at this point, I'm not getting that comment. But before we get to the commission, I will ask them to verify how they like those parking lot stub outs.
I was just curious. I've just never seen that.
Yes, sir. It's a good question. I just I would need their input to answer that, and I will follow up on that.
You know, with a three-story building, that would be kind of hard for a ladder truck to get in there and turn around in that little space, but that's...
It's a good question, sir. I just, you know, I want to ask them. So far, I can say they've seen the site plan. They haven't indicated anything to that effect, but it's worth asking again.
Just curious.
Commissioners, any other questions? Chris Fulton.
Jason. I see the, or it looks like, at least on the drawing, the southerly most exit on the Bemis Road. Looks like that goes, you know, people are wanting to go south on Bemis. They're going to go across two lanes of traffic into a turn lane.
Yes, sir.
I mean, is that a concern?
I think it is a concern. Ultimately, one requirement would be you restrict the turning movements to right in, right out, or B, you put a traffic light in there to try to address that movement and make it a safer movement. All I can tell you is right now, the people that I rely upon for that type of information are saying they don't believe that that would be required. But at the end of the day, it's going to be the state that makes that call, and they haven't given us something in writing to commit to that yet. So that's all I can report.
Has any thought been given to bring the second entrance out of the end of the parking lot on the north end?
That's actually...
Making a right turn on
Yes, sir.
There.
That's actually where they started. Their initial site plan to us had the entrance coming off closer to the northern end of the parking lot. But it didn't line up with that median crossing. But we believed, and the county engineer agreed, that he thought a more appropriate alignment would be an alignment with that median cut to give them the option of taking a left. So they started with a right in, right out only for the entire development and actually moved that median cut. They may be able to provide some background on that, but they started with your proposal and actually backed up to...
I guess what I'm saying is keep the one that goes across the median cut, but move the secondary to the northernmost end of the parking lot.
Oh.
So that you come in the main entrance and you can go right or straight. So you go out both ways and you have two exits, the other being right out. But anyway, that's...
Yes, sir. I see what you're saying now.
Developer, so.
I see that. That may be an option. I don't know about the spacing between the two, but that may just be a preference for the developer, sir.
Any other questions? I know, Jason, I just sitting here thinking about that right-hand turn exit, thinking about where the nearest traffic light is at, but I think that's about a stone's throw to Moody Airport thing, so.
You're getting closer. The nearest light, I believe, is probably Studstill Road to the south. It's probably the nearest light that you have out there.
There's no northbound light, is it?
No.
I mean, that one isn't Moody.
I mean, the next light to the north might be the Moody's new entrance, the south new Southgate entrance.
All right, I think you can turn left and go to Miller Farms, or turn right and go to the back Newgate, Moody.
Yes, sir. I think you're right. That's the next stop line. I agree. I mean, we had the conversation with the engineer. He just did not believe that this number of units would warrant that light.
Any other questions? There being none, we'll open to public participation now. Anyone here wishing to speak in favor of this request, please come forward this time. State your name and address for the record.
Bill Holland of Coleman Town, 910 North Patterson Street. I really don't have anything to add to this except Jason did a good job of laying it out. DHM Developers is the developer, and as Jason points out in his narrative in the package, They've done several projects. They are well known. They're well maintained, and they take good care of them. They design them well. I have Joe Chambers here. We can, as possible, we can answer any questions you may have had. But I know that they have, through Mike Fletcher, talked to the engineer and changed some designs already at his request. But we're here just to answer any questions if you can.
Commissioner, any questions,
sir? Another curiosity question. That it's cited the one in Hayhira. Is this the same developer that did the one in Hayhira, or are you saying it's similar to what they did?
No, it's the same developer. DHM Developers is a conglomerate of McLean Brown and Investors Management, I think.
And Investors Management did the one in Hayhira.
Yeah.
They did a great job up there, by the way.
Any other questions for presenter? Thank you, Mr. Thomas. Anyone else here wishing to speak in favor of this request, please come forward. Anyone here wishing to speak in favor of this request, please come forward, state your name and your address for record.
Rebecca Cameron, 3939 Yes Line.
Yes, ma'am.
And I support this part of it.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Any questions for the presenter? Thank you, ma'am, for coming tonight. Anyone else here wishing to speak in favor of this request, please come forward. There being none, is anyone here wishing to speak against this request? Anyone here wishing to speak against this request, please come forward. There being none, we'll close this part of the meeting tonight. Commissioners, any discussion amongst ourselves on this request for this evening?
I just have one quick question, if I may.
Yes, ma'am.
Staff, at this point, clearly there's going to be some adjustment to the site plan. For example, if it comes back from the state that the driveways are too close, we'll have to get the... So this is not really the final site plan you're approving tonight. This is a PD, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that typically an issue? I mean, I know that there's... I don't know. I could predict that there will be adjustments made. How does that typically work?
We try to... we ask the developer to give us the maximum intensity and, you know, a layout that we feel like we can recommend and have some tie to. And our ordinance says as soon as the commissioners adopt that site plan, it becomes an enforceable document. What we have done and previously have done as staff is we take that maximum number of units and make that a cap. So 80 units is a cap. So don't come back and ask for 85 or 90, and the developers understand that. But if you come back and make a modification and we need to ask for 65 units, we're probably not going to come back to the commission to ask for less units. If they move the entrances, we're probably not going back to the commission to ask for that based on the state response and approval. But if they did something like, you know, if they made those three-story buildings and they made them all two-story, they put the two stories against Stratford Circle, we probably would require a public hearing on that because we feel like it would be making those neighbors and their expectation to be more intense against their backyards. We feel like that would justify a public hearing. So we do try to give them some flexibility while maintaining what we feel like is a proper integrity. Generally, when we feel like there's a negative impact to the neighbors or something that goes against the integrity of what they presented, if they try to turn multifamily to single family, you know, that's a place in the past where we've gotten burned. So we make it more explicit now in the site plan to denote something like that. But generally, that's where we try to have caps and enforcement while still granting some flexibility based on a change from the state that we just don't know yet.
And as a follow-up question, is there a timeline expectancy for the project to get executed?
Right now, based on their application, I believe they're going to be applying this summer for these funds. I don't know their development timeline as far as this is how long it would take to actually construct them if they are successfully approved, but...
But typically, the county, there is no, you don't place a condition here.
Oh.
This plan is...
No, ma'am. I know some other local governments try to place a cap on the development timeline, but we've not gone down that road yet. At this point to say, look, you must develop this within 1 year or 3 years in order for it to come back and figure something else. We've not typically had that condition for us.
Any other questions for staff? Any other discussion amongst ourselves on this request? There being none, we will take a motion this time on this request.
Maybe we recommend approval to the county commission of this rezoning case.
Second. So we have Commissioner Folsom with a motion. Commissioner Willis, I believe, had the second. All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your right hand. 6-0 unanimous, Ms. Carmella.